May I ask you to close your eyes a little bit? Just let's close your eyes. Just let's relax. Close your eyes. I'm very happy to be here with you. You're gonna have to pay my car park later. You can open your eyes now. Thank you so much. I am out of order. I tried to find a really cool way of saying it yesterday. I didn't know how to, but yeah, I'm out of order. My name is Mariam Jam. I'm from Senegal, West Africa. But I've been living in here in England for 26 years now. I consider myself a very proud British. I created I Am the Code. I'll tell you a little bit of story why I created it. Unfortunately, I had a very difficult childhood. My mother abandoned myself and my twin brother, who lives in Germany today. We had a very traumatized childhood, my twin brother and I. And I was in Senegal, West Africa, in Kaolack. It was very, very tough. And this is my twin brother. That's the only picture we've got. Senegal is a very small country, but it's class and caste and systems. And at the age of 13 years old, I was trafficked from Senegal to Paris. I've never been to school. I've never had an education. I started reading my first alphabet when I was 16. I was in the hand of YMCA in France, it's a foyer called Saint-Denis. Extremely difficult childhood. I slept in a tube station in Paris, Boulevard Nation, if you know. Before I got picked up by the French government, that's how I got my French citizenship. They thought I was a young prostitute, but I wasn't. I was just saying yesterday that sometimes we don't know what trauma is unless you are out of order. There's so many millions of young women and girls out there today who've been through a lot in their life. Britain is my home. I have nowhere else to go. When I came here, I was 18, I was sent in a YMCA and walking. I was very scared there. And then they asked me to go to the Guildford one, the YMCA in Guildford, that's where I was. In cleaning jobs, working bars and hotels and restaurants. Just getting on with life, really. I did everything I can to make myself proud. When I got my citizenship, I was very proud because I knew that I deserved to be British. This country has done so much for me, I can't even pay it back. Then I start working, then get an education, start educating myself, going to the Guildford College, reading, going to the local library. And 2 years ago, I said, I'm gonna create something called I Am the Code. And I'll tell you how I Am the Code was born. I was in the bathroom, just January, going to Davos. I'm going there tomorrow. And I said to my son, I'm very scared, very worried, because I don't know what to say to those powerful people. He said, but mommy, you are the code. I said, yes, you're right, I am the code. And I went on Google, tried to find iamthecode.org. Iamthecode.com was taken. Iamthecode.org was available. And my son thinks that he's brand. He still thinks he owns it. I said, no, you don't. He thinks he owns it. So I created iamthecode.org, and I started thinking, what do I do if I am the code? And I started really putting all the ideas I had together, everything I've been doing, mentoring young women, meeting girls in marginalized communities. See, what do I do? How do I bring my life together? How do I create a story around I am the code to mobilize government, private sector, investors, philanthropic foundation, well-meaning people to do something about young women and girls? Because you see, our life doesn't define us. What happened to us as children doesn't define who we are. When I came in the UK, I never thought I'd stand up here talking to you guys. Never. I never thought that. But you see, we are out of order. That's why I created this audacious initiative called I Am The Code, because I think that women and girls need to be included, not tolerated. And so my mission is to make sure that 1 million young women and girls learn how to code by 2030. And why is that? It's because when I was at the Guildford Library, I didn't have any diploma, I didn't have any degree, I didn't have anything. I didn't have any education, really. And I used to go to the agency. The lady said, you know, we really like you, but unfortunately you don't have any diploma. Then I started the Guildford Library, memorizing the encyclopedia, reading dictionaries. And I came across HTML4 and started learning Excel, Excel for Dummies. And I started learning how to code my first blog. And you know, my first blog, this is very funny. My first blog, I addressed it to Bono. I don't like Bono. Does Bono have a friend here? If Bono have any friend here, please don't tell him. Don't tell him. I'm meeting him next week, so I will tell him. Because you know why I didn't like Bono? Because I was watching BBC. I didn't quite understand English very well, but I was watching BBC and seeing all those children, those poor children on TV. You know, I was like so angry inside, and I didn't know why BBC was showing all these pictures. I realized this guy has got so much power. Those images were talking to the British people, and then I met Bob Geldof. My God, it's like he's worse than Bono. He was worse. He was emotionally using us. I said, my God, you guys stop this. Why am I? This is you. This is, it's your fault I'm here. And the guy said, no, it's not. I said, yes. Because the way they were talking about aid and poverty was so different. And I started blogging. So my first open letter was addressed to Bono. That's how I learned how to code my first blog. I always tell him, always laugh. He said, I changed your life. I said, no, you know. No, you haven't. So then what I wanted to do is to make sure the way I learned how to code 7 languages in 2 years, so I code from Python to Java. I'm a good Python coder, so I'm a full Slack. So I code I code websites, that's what I do. And now I sell technologies around the world. And we came really from nothing. And what I want to share with you today is, you know, not only you can come from really zero to disrupt a lot of stuff around the world. So I go and lobby people and tell them what poverty really is and how you can change people's life by being empathetic, compassionate, kind, and just listen to people. We are one, we are made, we're just one. I travel around the world. I Am The Code is now in 56 countries. Well, so far, we released so many young women and girls, not just in Africa, but in Brazil, in China, in Japan, everywhere, even in the UK, my home. And the reason why I do this is because I want to show the world that we need to disrupt things. We need to make sure that young women and girls growing around the world who are not privileged, don't have access to education, can't read and write, growing from slums. So when you see Donald Trump talking about shithole, excuse my language, he doesn't know anything about shithole. He doesn't. So I wrote a blog the other day telling a difference between a slum and what he's calling Africa. Because I meet girls in slums. They're brave, they're confident, and they really know what they want. So those girls are from favelas in Brazil. I go to Brazil and get girls from favelas. Without I Am The Code, they get pregnant. teenagers. They have no chance, no dreams. And this is reality, this is fact. It's not fake news. It's fact. And we need to help them. That's what I do. And the reason, and one of the things, I think sometimes when you like, when you want to become something, an out of order person, out of the ordinary, or you want to do things to that mobilize, you need to think about a goal, a big goal. And I don't know if you're aware of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, but I thought that the only way we can make a difference and make sure the United Nations is accountable for their actions is to start focusing on what really matters for all of us. You know, we all want the same thing. We all want the same thing. It doesn't matter who you are. If you are wealthy, poor, rich, wherever you are, we all want the same thing. And people always ask me, what is that thing? We all want love. We all want compassion. We all want kindness. We all want to be listened to. We all want someone to say to us, I am here for you. Unfortunately, I don't have a family. The only person I've got is my son. But you know, imagine people who are living around the world with no family, no mother, no father. We can't change the way society has put us here. But we can go forward and become out of order people, unusual people. I was saying to you earlier, when I came to the UK, I never thought I'll stand up here talking to you. I also never thought that people I've been fighting for and by fighting with, the Bono type, Bob Geldof type, that I'll be recognized by the United Nations last year. I've never thought that. But you need to be an out of order person to know that at the end, you have a big mission. I am not scared. I'm not afraid. You know, my scare came out from the tube station in Paris when I was in the cold. So I've been having chest problem since I was young because I was living in a very, very deep cold. I was homeless. And this is traumatic, and it follows you as you grow up. So today, if I can stand up here and tell you that I was nominated by the United Nations, because of my work, I go and slam doors and tell them you need to help women and girls around the world. We need to listen to girls and women because we are out of all the people. I want you to create your own story as you go home. Small changes do add up and they make great things. They do. Small things. Small things. Sometimes you just think, oh, it's not okay. It's very small what I do. But actually it doesn't. Join the out of order club. It's okay to be yourself. It's really okay. It's okay to fight. It's okay to be angry. It's okay to go and tell the world this is not what we want. It's really okay. It's okay to go and fight for the Me Too movement. It's okay to go and march. Because you know what? We're very comfortable with where we are, and there's a lack of sense of empathy and compassion around the world today. But when you have 1 million in women and girls waiting for you to teach them how to code, I'm talking about digital literacy, very small languages, Python, Java, Ruby, that will give them a chance to become proud, dignified, have a job. It's like what the United Kingdom did for me. I can go today and tell the whole world what the United Kingdom did for me. I'm a proud citizen. I pay tax. I give back to my country. I have nowhere to go. This is my home. I don't have no house in Senegal. I have nowhere to go. So while I'm at it, I'm going to make my country very proud. But you have to do it with authenticity. Do it because you are who you are. My childhood doesn't define me because I'm an out of order person. I'm very unusual and I can move forward to make a difference. Never be afraid. Never be courageous. Thank you.